In Olanya's post-mortem report, which the Minister of Health, Dr. Jane Ruth Achen, read to Parliament today, the former Speaker succumbed to multiple organ failure. She notes that the liver started failing while he was in Uganda and fluid had collected in his lungs.
The immediate cause of death was multi-organ failure. The heart failed, the lungs failed, the liver failed, and the kidney failed. The liver started failing while he was still here in Uganda, as well as the lungs that had started collecting fluid. The heart started failing while in Seattle, as well as the kidneys. He had multiple infections, bacterial infections, which were discovered here, and viral infections that were discovered in Seattle. And unfortunately, the treatment for the viral infections also further suppressed the bone marrow. This was a consequence of total bone marrow suppression, which we call pancytopenia. In other words, his bone marrow could no longer produce red blood cells, white blood cells, or platelets. And he lived on blood and platelets every day. All this resulted from progressive, recurrent, diffuse, large B-cell, non-Hodgkin's lymphoma. That is the cancer.
Achen says that Olanya was diagnosed with cancer in 2019 following a swelling on the neck. He sought medical attention in Germany, where it was confirmed.
In 2019, he discovered a swelling in the neck. It was a relatively big swelling, and he took it upon himself to seek medical attention in Germany. The swelling was removed and analyzed, and he was told it was a cancer.
Olanya had visited several hospitals, but due to the travel bans during the lockdown and challenges in elections, he was not able to receive the necessary treatment.
He was started on treatment, which he finished in Uganda Cancer Institute. He subsequently visited several other hospitals because of the same. But we also had challenges during the lockdown and during the elections when he was not able to be in hospital. On the 23rd of January, we admitted him to Mulago, where he was to stay for 2 weeks. And during that time, were preparing him to travel and also getting in touch with several hospitals that could provide a gene therapy treatment known as the CAR T cell. He had a lymphatic system depletion. The Right Honorable Speaker lost his spleen while he was in Makerere. And I'm sure many of you are aware about this. It is the spleen. And my brother, Right Honorable Kotogong, allow me to correct you. It is not the pancreas. You cannot live without a pancreas. It was the spleen. He had a splenectomy following that riot. So he didn't have a spleen, which is also an organ that manufactures blood cells, white, red, and so on. He also had challenges with stem cell, which had a poor immune response because of chemotherapy.
This revelation has left some politicians concerned and tasked government to apologize for the shooting and review its armed operations against civilians. This report was compiled by Fred Kajubi for the news.